Hello, Kirsty here today to talk about the Carnegie books and predict my winner. Now, the Carnegie Awards, I've always had a bit of a love-hate relationship with it. I often find the long list gives me an awful lot of things to pick up and read that I haven't necessarily read before, even though I do read a huge amount of YA and children's books. And then the short list comes through and I'm always disappointed. And while there's usually a couple on there that I really, really enjoy, the rest of them not so much. So, Carnegie Award, yes, sometimes I like it, sometimes I don't. This year the shortlist has proved quite disappointing for me, which really narrows down what I'm going to talk about in this video, because there are only three books on the Carnegie shortlist this year that I felt I could actually finish or could even be bothered to pick up in the first place. So, without bashing Carnegie too much more, because I can then see the librarians descending with their comments, let's talk about the three books on the Carnegie list that I actually liked, and I'm going to predict my winner. So, Apple and Rain was one of the books that came to me quite late. I didn't read it in hardback, although I do have a hardback because Sarah doesn't like hardbacks that I do. I read this in paperback not long back actually, and I really, really enjoyed it. It's a really nice story, and yeah, I really, really enjoyed this one. I thought it was well worth a look. So, third place for me is that one. Second place for me is Patrick Ness More Than This. It's a really, really stunning book. It blew my mind at the end of it. I don't even really know how to describe it because I just couldn't at the time. I think my review went, mind officially blown. And that was it, because I had nothing else to say really. Not to say it isn't stunning, because it is, but this is one that I don't think I could ever do just in review. You need to review for yourself. And actually, secretly, I probably think this one's going to win. It's not the one I'd pick, but I do think this one's going to win. The book that I think should win, but I think Patrick Ness's books win, is this book. This book is brilliant. I read this almost 2 years ago now. Almost 2 years ago? That's rubbish. Like January before last. And I loved every page of it. Yes, it's rude. Yes, it's got foul language. And I think it's the reason why it probably won't win, because it will put different people off reading it. Because I've seen bits and pieces on Twitter lately that say, oh, is your child allowed to read this? And all that kind of rubbish. Kids swear. They just do. There you go. I loved it. To me, it was what Curious Nighttime, Curious Instant in the Nighttime, yeah, did for autistic children. I think this will do for Tourette's. It's a stunning book. I enjoyed every second page of it. I loved the main character, Dylan. He made me laugh an awful lot. And if I was picking the winner of the Carnegie Award, this would be it, because I think it's a brilliant, brilliant book. However, as I said before, I actually think this one will win, which wouldn't make me unhappy at all.